मैं आप सबको ग्रीट करना चाहूँगी. तुम्ही सगळ्यांना गुढी पाडवाच्या हार्दिक शुभेच्छा. माय नेम इज डॉक्टर गजाला शेख. आय एम अ युनानी फिजिशियन बेस्ड इन नवी मुंबई. अँड फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आय वुड लाईक टू थँक हेल्प लायब्ररी, द टीम ऑफ हेल्प लायब्ररी विच इज गिविंग युनानी, गिविंग मी दिस व्हेरी वंडरफुल प्लेटफॉर्म where we are able to create awareness about Unani medicine, its wonderful history, its logical principle and its effective remedies and different treatment modalities. So I thank from deep of my heart from the entire Unani fraternity to help. Friends, today I'm going to speak on temperament, that is Mizaj. In Urdu it's called Mizaj, in English we call it as temperamental theory, which is one of the basic fundamentals of Unani medicine. Aur kyunki mausam ne bhi apna mizaj badla hai, so I preferred today to speak on this very relevant concept of Mizaj. And as usual I have tried to, as you can see in my presentation, I am trying to correlate this principles of Unani medicine with modern science and how it is applied in modern world, not as a health philosophy but in the field of psychiatry and management, because I believe that the Unani physician or ancient scholar speak the language of philosophy and it needs to transform into the language of science. So it's my little effort for doing that. So let's begin the presentation. As I told you, the Unani revolves around the concept of umure tabayya, which is Urdu, and you can translate it as principle of human physiology. The entire body is made up of these seven components which work together and the health of a person is maintained. The first one is arkan, that is elements. Second is ikhlat, which is humor. Third, which is the topic of today's talk, which is mizaj, that is temperament. Ruh, that is spirit or nima. Aza, that means organs of the body. Kava, that means power. And at last, afal, that means the functions of those organs. Now I always told that Unani, which is originated from the land of Greece, it was developed by the Middle East and finally it is now a well accepted and widely practiced system of medicine next to very popular Ayurveda and homeopathy. In India, Unani has prospered as we have 6 regional research centers, 31 undergraduate colleges and 4 postgraduate institutes. So the land of India has really prospered and adopted Unani very well.
Do you have a research center in Bombay?
Yes, in Mumbai we had in JJ Hospital. We have a center, regional center, that is called CCRUM. This is Central Council of Research in Unani Medicine. If you go to the premises of JJ Hospital, we, yeah. Yeah, it's near the old bit. Now the Unani philosophy based on the number 4. We have 4 elements, 4 humors and 4 temperaments. This is called the Anasire Arba, that means 4 elements. The whole world and the universe is composed of these 4 elements, earth, air, water and fire. Each one is having a quality like cold and dry. Air is hot and moist. Water is having quality of cold and moist. Fire is hot and dry. Now, cold and hot, these are two dominant qualities which is present in any element, and dry and moist is a recessive quality. Now, if you look at, now today when we look at the periodic table, we have 103 elements according to their atomic numbers. But here we believe that the human body is a microsome of the universe. So the same thing which is comprising the universe is also present in the human body. So if you go to the analysis of the elements which is present in earth, these are 28 elements which are present in the earth. And now look at the chemical composition of human body. These are 18 elements, and except iron, cobalt and selenium, except these three, cobalt, selenium and iodine, that last one, except these three elements, all the elements are present in earth. So it's very interesting that though the health philosophy which is based on the elements is primitive, it's still very logical, and we can correlate it with the modern science. Now come to the literally meaning of Mizaj. The Unani physician defined Mizaj as the word is from the word imtizaj. In Latin it is temperer, which means intermixing. Now what happened? It simply is A plus B is equal to C. Now A is having certain kind of qualities. B is having its certain kind of qualities like hot, cold, and the resultant, the product which is formed out of the interaction of these two elements is having its unique temperament and qualities, which is called as Mizaj.
Can you give an example?
Yeah. Like, as I'll go on, because it is the literally definition, so what happened when two elements combine with each other? They interact, each one having their own quality. So when they interact, there is enhancement or overcome of one quality by the other till a level of equilibrium is attained, and that equilibrium state is called as temperament of that particular resultant resultant thing that is formed out of that interaction. The modern definition is temperament is existing dynamic state of the body at which function and structure is in perfect harmony with the ambient biosphere, and the subject enjoys survival and holistic health. Now, as we know that the body comprises of different kind of tissue, then we have organ and different organ system. So the Unani medicine revolves around the concept that whether a living thing or an unliving thing, both having they are all attributed with this quality called as temperament. It's not like that the living things only have temperament. All the non-living thing has also been attributed by this quality called Mizaj. Now, as we are concerned here with the human body, these are the different in this chart. Like you can see, there are four qualities, and these are the organs which are listed according to the level of their qualities. Such, for example, the skin. Skin is the organ of the body which is very neutral. Whereas if you will see the blood, you see the liver, these organs have a specific kind of, that is called their inherent temperament. Jo unka mizaj hai, hakiki hota hai, jo unka tabai mizaj hai. Tabai mizaj, that means ke they have to be into this particular quality, like the liver and the blood. Blood is carrying innate heat. That's why it is having the quality of hot and wet. Similarly, the part of the body such as bone which is cold and dry, because it is not having very active metabolic activity going on, such as your hair. Hair is also the dead filament, it is dead protein filament, and it doesn't have any metabolic activity, that's why it is also a cold and dry part of your body. Similarly, we have cold and dry liver, which is the hottest organ, and each one, nail is also cold and dry. So each organ of the body has a particular inherent temperament, and it needs to be in that particular temperament only to enable its function. What happens if the organ will lose their inherent temperament? We call that stage of distemperament, and that will make that organ more prone for getting into the disease. Like the liver. Liver is a soft organ which is very squishy. It is hot and wet because it is generating blood. It is a hot bed of metabolic activities. It is the factory of the body. So it needs to be hot and wet to perform its function well. In case if liver becomes hard, what happens in the cirrhosis of liver? The liver becomes hard. So it started the disease process. Then it is not a normal liver. We believe that Unani medicine, it's imperative for the body and each and every part. The health of each and every organ is important. So the health of the liver is, as far as its function is concerned, it has to be in the state of hot and wet. If it will lose its hotness, then it will go into the, it will be more vulnerable to the disease processes, and it's not able to carry out its function.
So how can we help to make it hot?
Yeah, I'll keep on telling you. It's now, as I told you, umure tabayya mein there are temperament ke baad, the next was the humor. As I always told you that Unani medicine is based on the humor theory, where we have four types of body fluids, which is called as dam, that is blood. Then we have second as phlegm or balgam. Then third is yellow bile, or we call in Urdu safra. And the fourth one is black bile, or called as soda. So these four kinds of humor are also be given a particular type of temperament. As you can see here, it is the earth ailment and air ailment. The temperament, which is the humor which is exhibiting this property, is black bile. Similarly, fire and earth, the combination of this is yellow bile. Fire and water, it is this is comprising of the period of spring, that is the most ideal, that is called the blood, that is, and here it is phlegm, which is having the quality of water and air. So these are the humors. Each of the humor is having its own temperament. And similarly, if you fall into wrong diet habits, these humor also loses their inherent temperament and you become